Secret Santa 2015. Mix 107.5 and you.
Up and
making
running.
A difference.
Up and running. You guys donated $22,000 to Secret Santa this year. And because of that, 11 families who probably would not have had Christmas. And if they did, it certainly wouldn't have been a very good Christmas. Well, they are getting Christmas this year. It's all because of you guys. Start to finish. It's time for another Secret Santa delivery for 2015. Made this delivery last night. Excited to play it for you on the radio. So you can hear where your donations go. That money that you put in for Secret Santa, this is where it goes. This is how it's spent for you guys, okay? I'm going to read for you a letter that came in for this family. The letter was sent in by Alexandria. She says, it all started on Mother's Day. So it goes back. These guys have been dealing with this for a little time now. It goes back to Mother's Day. She, the mom, had been complaining about a headache, and nothing would help take it away. She went to the hospital several times, and they never could figure out quite what was going on. It got so bad that one day she was taking her kids to school, and she had to pull over and have somebody come get her. She was getting dizzy and lightheaded and couldn't drive anymore. Her partner, Melissa, came to get her and took her to the hospital again, and once again, they couldn't find anything. One day, she started vomiting blood. Melissa took her to the doctor. They did a CT of her stomach and said she had an ulcer, and that is why she was vomiting blood. At that time, she also told them about her headache, and they just couldn't do anything. The next day, her head was hurting so bad, she couldn't take it anymore. And so her partner took her to the clinic in Portales, and right away they did a CT, this time of her brain, and found that she had bleeding and swelling on her brain. On May 13th, she was airlifted to Lubbock and was diagnosed with venous malfunction, which means that her capillaries in her brain didn't fuse together like they should have when she was a baby. While she was in the hospital, they did several CTs to monitor the bleeding and the swelling. Bleeding finally stopped and formed a blood clot on her brain, and the doctor said that they needed to perform surgery to remove it and repair her brain, but they couldn't do the surgery until she regained her strength. So they said that until they could perform the surgery, they were going to inject her with a glue to hold the blood clot in place, which makes sense, so it didn't move or break off, which could cause a lot of damage. During the procedure, there was another blood clot that they hadn't seen earlier. That blood clot did break loose and went shooting across her brain. They were able to break it up and dissolve it, but it caused her to have several mini strokes, leaving her disabled. She's now legally blind, lost over 50% of vision in her left eye, and the left side of her body is still weak. Since then, she has had the surgery and slowly getting better. She still has trouble with her memory. She went from working full-time and going to school to being permanently disabled. She's having trouble getting her disability to go through and has a family to support. We can verify that. We were there last night. She and her partner, two girls, two teenage girls.
Yeah.
Very excited.
Yes.
She has a family to support. This is a person that would help anyone in a heartbeat. She's strong-willed and hates asking for help, so she doesn't know I'm doing this for her. Was on to say a couple other nice things about her. We found out in talking to the nominator that she'd been in and out of the hospital. Found out that, yeah, there's still some memory issues, which makes sense considering the condition.
Mm-hmm.
Found out that if she gets too excited, could black out, things like that. It made us a little nervous, frankly.
Yeah.
Here we are showing up literally with 20 people and a bunch of vehicles.
Loud,
making all kinds of noise.
Mm-hmm.
So we tried to tone it down a little bit, just to make sure everybody was safe. This family was shot for by Bianca and Elvita. and went out this past weekend and shopped. And then, of course, the high school swim team wrapped everything up. S&S Supermarket, Carpet Tech, Sparkle Cleaners, Clovis Fire Department, our helper elves over there, been helping us for a decade, even more. All got together. And last night, Secret Santa paid this particular family a visit.
It's Secret Santa 2015, and here we are. It's Monday night. You're hearing this back on Tuesday morning. You just heard the letter for this nice family, very deserving of a Secret Santa visit, going through a real struggle right now. As we head out towards the house, we're having fun here in the mix machine with our helper elves. Amber Kay, did you get everything put together?
Yeah, Jingle Baca. Uh-huh. He's driving us. He's our driver elf.
You've been upgraded from helper elf to driver elf.
Yep, I got a promotion now.
In the lineage of elf, that means you're one step closer to Santa. Very much looking forward to delivering to this family and making a memory. Okay, we turned off the highway now, and we are on the road where the family lives. We understand it's a dead-end road, and they're all the way down at the end. And here, Baca, let me show you this. Helper Elf Baca, that's the vehicle that we're looking for in the driveway. This is one of those times with Secret Santa every year where you're thankful for GPS because these folks live pretty far out. All right, so here we go. We are turning officially on the dead-end road, and it's our understanding that it's right at the end. We're driving through a field right now is what's happening to get back. And yeah, there's the vehicle. Okay, we are here. We're getting out. I'm going to try not to alarm anybody as we show up and deliver Christmas for this family. Very deserving family. We're making our way up to the front right now. Okay, we are making our way up. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Hi. How are y'all doing?
Good.
Who lives here? Who lives? Hi, do you live here?
Yes.
Ma'am, can we come into your home?
Yeah.
Okay. She looks really concerned right now, Amber.
Well, I would too if you're not.
Let's come on inside. I'll tell you who we are. If we can come in, we'll tell you who we are. We'll come back over here. Someone point to it and tell us where to go. Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
What's your name?
Lisa.
Lisa, my name is Duffy Moon, and this is Amber Kay from Mix 107.5 Radio, and we do a radio show, and every year we do a program on our show that we call Secret Santa. What we do is we look for families that maybe are going through a little bit of a struggle this year, and we offer to bring them Christmas, and your family was nominated, and if you say yes, we would sure like to bring Christmas to your family.
Yes.
Come on in, guys. Come on in. Are those your daughters?
Yes, but these two are my daughters.
Can we say hello to everybody?
All right, good.
Come on. Hi, how are you?
I'm good.
All right. And hi, how are you?
Good.
You seem very excited.
Yes.
What's happening is all these folks are bringing in for you guys a Christmas tree. Outside of that, we have decorations for you and food for Christmas, and then the good stuff comes in. You guys want some presents?
Yeah.
Mom, are you doing okay?
Yeah. I'm just nervous.
I don't know if you heard what we said, but what's going on right now is our friends at S&S Supermarket have donated food for your entire family so you guys can cook up a Christmas dinner, okay?
Okay.
And then we have a tree over there from Carpet Tech and some decorations as well. And then, of course, lots of gifts. We have lots of gifts coming in for you.
Wow. Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Are you able to tell us kind of what's going on this year? I understand it's been a bit of a struggle for you guys.
I had, in May, I've worked all the way up until May, I had an aneurysm in my brain, so I haven't been able to work since.
How you feeling right now?
I'm pretty good right now. I'm actually recovering well. I just had brain surgery. So.
And you said a little bit nervous right now.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, all these people in your home, right?
Yes.
So how are we looking, elves? All right, good, good. Well, everybody's made their way in here. And you guys, does that look like enough gifts for you?
Yes.
Are you guys excited about that?
Yeah.
Hi, what's your name?
Pharaoh.
How are you today?
Good.
How old are you, buddy?
9.
What do you see right over there?
Presents.
Lots of them, huh?
Yeah.
We're talking to the nominator right over here. What did you say?
I said I'm going to get killed later.
Amber, I think you said it earlier. We got here at the right time.
Yeah, I'm totally distracted.
There's a full spread of food out here right now. What time are you serving dinner?
Now?
All right, perfect. That was the right answer. How are we looking, elves? All right, good. Excellent. Well, Mom, we're just going to kind of wrap things up over here with you real quick. First of all, we want to make sure that you and your family have a Merry Christmas. And this nice lady over here nominated, and she wanted to make sure that you guys had a real good Christmas, okay?
Thank you.
We understand that things have been a little tough for you this year, so we worked it out with the listeners at Mix 107.5. We have one final gift for you and your family, and that's $1,000 in cash.
Thank you.
Put it to good use?
Yes. Doctor's appointments and everything, we live in Lubbock, so.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
You guys want to sing them a Christmas carol?
Yeah.
Of course you do. Yeah, yeah. All right. How about jingle bells on three? Here we go. One, two, three.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey!
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you so much.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe.
If you say yes, we would sure like to bring Christmas to your family.
Help to make the season bright.
Yes.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
You seem very excited.
Yes.
Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep. Tonight.
What do you see right over there?
Presents.
Lots of them, huh?
Yeah.
They know that Santa's on his way.
You guys want some presents?
Yeah.
He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase.
Mom, are you doing okay?
Yeah, I'm just nervous.
How are you feeling right now?
I'm pretty good right now. I'm actually recovering well. I just had brain surgery.
Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good.
What time are you serving dinner?
Now?
All right, perfect. That was the right answer. Are you able to tell us kind of what's going on this year? I understand it's been a bit of a struggle for you guys.
I had, I've worked all up until May. I had a aneurysm in my brain, so I haven't been able to work since.
We have one final gift for you and your family, and that's $1,000 in cash.
Thank you.
Put it to good use?
Yes.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you so much.
Happy Holidays.